Cyber by David Sloma. Copyright 2004 to 2011 David Sloma. All rights reserved. Seamless data flow brings words and images together on a screen. Two beings inside the data stream, the cyber world. Unaware of each other, but soon to meet. Xavier, a boy on the edge of being a man, and Lenore, a woman with deep beauty, her soul old and wise. Representations of human beings, avatars, they are called. Wandering through endless landscapes and corridors, they look small and lost, like thousands of tiny jewels sparkling in newly fallen snow. They are alone in the machine's pixelated space. Data creeps across the visual field, become pictures. They see each other's avatars. Xavier sends out a hi and a hello, answers from Lenore. He taps the keys, and then squeezes into a reflex glove so he can touch her hand so far away. They join hands in phase space and feel the electronic touch of the other. So real, yet they are so far apart. I've never been here before. It's so beautiful, he says.
Come with me. I want to show you around, she says, smiling.
She leads him by the virtual hand, down a corridor of vermilion tiles, which shimmer into millions of other colors as they pass by. Xavier is high on emotion. His heart feels warm. They mingle in thoughts, grow in dreams. All is possible here. They are flying as birds above the city and mountains. In deep sea dives they are fish at play. Then, they become great clouds of red and purple nebulas and pulsating stars, swirling forever in a computer-generated universe. He becomes a tree, growing from an acorn before her, into a giant oak. I feel so good when you are here with me, Xavier says. I've always wished to find someone like you, Lenore. All the bitter, alone years growing up in the harsh world don't matter much now, he tells her. Lenore smiles, some wrinkles appearing, her experience showing.
I was an actress when I was young. I lived my life for the screen. Now, I am become an image, she says. And this is only the cyber world. But, it's not all bad. She smiles. Here I can look like whomever I wish.
She changes into a thousand different beautiful women of every color and shape. She becomes the monsoon that washes over him, her face in every drop. She wishes she could see behind his eyes. Distance doesn't matter anymore, yet now it matters more than before. Once distance separated these two souls, yet here they fuse as one inside a machine. Bodies become irrelevant in this spaceless moment, this timeless space. It's almost as if heaven had opened and they found each other wandering in Eden after rain. It's been months now since their first electronic meeting. They have grown closer in emotions without ever having moved their bodies any nearer. If distance were taken away, would they feel the same? They meet again and again, in cyberspace. Where are you from? Xavier asks.
You mean where was I from? Before? She says. I was a lonely person like you were. Looking for my one true love to make me whole. Now I am the one who is lost.
She looks sad as she turns away, her avatar now her own face. Soon, Xavier becomes unsatisfied with the electronic choruses. He wants to touch her face, feel her flesh. Meet me. He pleads.
Why ruin a good thing? She asks.
Please? Xavier begs. I want to meet you. For real. Do it for me, please, Lenore. Reluctantly, she acquiesces. They arrange to meet. He takes a jet. Soon they will be together. He smiles on the plane. All the way across the world to meet his love. So many questions in his mind, fit to burst. He holds the cup with ice to his forehead. Water mingles with sweat. Where to start? Xavier sighs to himself. Xavier arrives at the address, but this cannot be right. Only an office tower, not her home he dreamed of. Walking inside, he looks up at the ceiling lights. So cold and vacant, they hurt his eyes. Coming now to the room she told him. His hand on the handle. Opening the door. Stepping inside. he finds a computer taller than he is, a life-sized tower of electronic mind. Lenore? Where are you? He calls out.
Suddenly, her voice, I am here. In the computer. Walk through the portal and you will enter the machine. We will meet there.
A speaker on the table goes silent. There is a circle of laser light on the floor. Buzzing. He steps inside and everything changes. He is transformed into a digital flow of electrons, broken down into pixels of lights, sparkling bright. It's very painful for a second or two. He is taken inside the machine, and there he finds his love. They embrace. This is how they remember it. They smile. Time passes, unnoticed, unconcerned. Fluid.
Finally, she moves from him, shaking her head. You must return. You cannot stay here forever. Like me.
Go back where?
To the world.
But, I want to stay here. This is my home now. With you. Xavier takes her electronic hand.
It is my home, not yours. You have other things to accomplish. A real life to live. She says.
I want you to come with me.
I cannot leave. My body of flesh is gone. This is where I live out my dreams and be who I am. Or what is left to me. She sighs. I am sorry, but your home is back in real life. Go now. The portal. I am sorry.
I will visit you. I will never forget you.
Please? You must visit me. I am so alone here. Lenore says.
A digital tear falls down her cheek. Xavier walks away, dropping her hand. Ahead, the portal is still open, but shrinking fast. He jumps in and it closes, transporting him back to the world. Outside the machine, he slumps down on the floor, stunned. In a numb daze, he realizes that he must go back to his city, his life. He stands on feeble legs and puts his hand on the computer, looking at the signal lights flashing as activity flutters within. No, he vents his sadness and hangs his sorrow-filled head. Why do things have to be so cruel for me? The speaker comes to life and Lenore's voice comes through again.
Be strong. I will be here for you, always.
Xavier stills dreams of Lenore, in the cyber world. Some quiet nights, long after midnight, he finds himself connecting to that machine. He can never stay with her, but he can visit. And dream. David Sloma is a writer and filmmaker. His site is www.davidsloma.com.